Here in Monrovia, Liberia, the hospitals are completely overloaded. There's no room for new patients, and as the virus continues to spread, there is not the ability within the medical structure here to keep up to fight it.
Last week, New York Times reporter Ben C. Solomon sent us his exclusive report on the largest Ebola outbreak in history. More than 2,800 people are dead across West Africa, and the CDC estimates that as many as 1.4 million people could be infected by the end of January. 1.4 million people. People who may have absolutely nowhere to go, like this 20-year-old man who Ben filmed outside the JFK hospital in Monrovia, Liberia.
As sick as he is, he won't be allowed inside. The largest hospital in the nation, and many others just like it, are completely full.
It's heartbreaking. There's nothing I can do about it because I have no space. I don't have the capacity.
Here at the Doctors Without Borders Treatment Center, they too are at capacity.
Doctors Without Borders is currently operating 5 Ebola management centers in Monrovia, the largest city to be hit with the virus. But what is it about this virus in particular? Why is Ebola so deadly? It's a complicated disease, but Hank Green's recent SciShow episode is the best quick explainer that we found.
Ebola is a type of hemorrhagic fever, which means one of its most prominent symptoms is heavy bleeding, either internally or externally. But blood loss isn't what kills its hosts. After causing flu-like symptoms like vomiting and diarrhea, Zebov targets the entire circulatory system, causing blood vessels to fail, blood pressure to drop, and eventually all of the major organs to shut down.
Right now, the disease kills up to 90% of people who contract it, but with access to proper care, that number could really drop significantly. And the number of people being infected, period, would drop with a better knowledge where the disease comes from and how it spreads. Believe it or not, bats are one of the culprits behind the rapid spread of the virus. Minute Earth posted this explaining why.
All of these nasty pathogens have surfaced in humans in just the last 50 years, and they are all carried by bats. The recent rise in outbreaks is likely due to humans and our animals creeping ever farther into bats' territory, especially in the tropics. In Malaysia, for example, the spread of commercial pig farms into bat-inhabited forests led to the first human outbreak via pigs of Nipah.
A huge part of the problem is that people eat bats in Western Africa, and while some countries have actually banned the sale of bat meat, some people continue to eat it. Doctors Without Borders and other nonprofits are doing everything they can to educate people about the dangers of eating bushmeat, but the truth of the matter is they just can't reach everyone. They don't have the resources. That said, throughout this crisis, true local heroes have emerged, like the Burial Boys of Sierra Leone.
A ragtag group of around 20 men, most in their early 20s, that make up the dead body management team in eastern Sierra Leone.
When somebody dies from this virus, that body is more dangerous.
One unsafe touch can put an entire village at risk.
I sacrifice myself for my country.
I sleep in the struggle room now. Because of our part of the burial team, all of my family are disowned me now.
Reporting here is a really complicated task. You have to really stay vigilant, protect yourself from getting the virus. It's not easy to watch this virus spread, but it's important to kind of tell the stories of the people here and understand the human aspect of the people dying in this complicated situation.
We all need to help Ben tell these stories. Share this video because it's a great way to raise awareness. And if you want to go one step further, they are in desperate need of resources.
If you look back in time, MSF have been able to cope with outbreaks that have been going on from year to year because they have been small. But at the moment, we are down on our knees. So who else is there?
Please consider donating. Even a little bit will help them immensely. All you got to do is use this little button in the upper left-hand corner. You could donate immediately, or we got a link for you down in the description.
Africa, we can stick together to kick this Ebola away. Papagato, restore everything that is broken. Back to the, back to the. See the people and children are dying. Oh, restore back, Mama Africa, restore the land. Restore